As you learn about AF, you'll notice that there's a lot of emphasis on the ease of finding things, which tends, I believe, to suggest that this is really only useful for people who have very, very large PI systems with lots of assets. I'd like to describe AF right now, and keep in mind, those of you who have smaller PI systems, say 10,000 tags or less, there are some very good reasons for using AF that I'd like to convince you of later on. So what we're looking at right now is the PI System Explorer. This is not AF. This is a view into AF. So you wouldn't really say this is AF any more than you would say PI SMT, for example, is the PI data archive. Now, this is just one view. As you can see, what this view shows us is that we're looking at a more hierarchical structure than what you normally see when you work with the PI system. So what we're doing with AF is leaving the kind of server-centric approach of the PI server and going more towards an enterprise-wide or company-wide approach to looking at data. The way I like to describe it is, you know, when you're looking at a PI system without AF, your main window is a tag search. That's kind of like using a Rolodex to find the people in your organization. That's fine. When you have a large enough organization, though, you really would like some better mechanism for finding things quickly. And also, there's all kinds of nice reporting mechanisms that become available once you've divided up your processes or your assets a certain way. So, again, we're less focused on PI tags and more focused now on user objects called elements. Now, we'll take a look at a lot more detail later on, but for example, this what we're about to look at right now is a set of elements. This is the elements called YulFM004. That element has a series of attributes, in this case just one attribute. But these elements now are our view into that particular asset. As you can see, some of the assets have many attributes, some of them just have one. But the core concept is that now we have an element, and that element can have attributes associated with it that are either PI tags or some other data source. You know, simply speaking, what we've done is added an asset model to your data. So now, as you can see, using a hierarchical structure here, I can create that asset model so that it models divisions, for example, or so that it models geography. Or I can get it to model anything else. A yield accountant might look at it different than an instrument technician. So those two groups would model it differently. And I can drill down through these different assets to find just the thing that I'm interested in. Now, in addition to be able to search for things using this tree structure, we also have categories that you can assign elements to. So searches by category are possible now. Now, as you might guess, what comes with this new kind of asset-oriented or object-oriented view is an object-oriented security that was not available before. And also, one important thing, the difference between using AF to find things and a traditional tag search is we can scale this to 100 million elements if we need to, each one with hundreds of attributes. So it really is much more scalable, much larger in scope than the traditional PI server and the tag-oriented searches. Now, here's an illustration in PowerPoint that tries to make the point of what we're doing here. Imagine a traditional PI server. Traditional PI server, this site A, it is getting data from these different data sources here, these different vendors of hardware that are controlling your system and generating real-time data. We have vendor-specific interfaces that grab that data, as well as some generic standard interfaces, all of which is being reported over to this PI server. And that actually might be something that's repeated on several different PI servers. So for example, you know, we may have a site A and a site B, two PI servers. When you do a tag search, you would be searching individually through site A and then site B. In addition, you may have some non-time series type of data that you're interested in. So for example, your supply chain management system has data that would be of obvious interest to those in manufacturing. Same for your relational database, your manufacturing execution system. All of these things are things that would be of interest to folks that are in manufacturing. So what we've tried to do with AF is to make all of that as easy as possible for you to find by providing this layer. I know the developers like to call it an abstraction layer, whatever you want to call it. It's a guide. It's a way to find these things. So by overlaying your existing Pi servers and all the data that's contained under those Pi servers, along with all the data that comes from systems other than Pi, putting that under one, centralized search mechanism and exposing that to all the different clients that require that data, we hope to accomplish the overall goal of giving people in manufacturing every bit of information they might need for making decisions. And of course, making decisions that are going to lead to increased profitability. So again, in summary, what we're looking at is really a way to take all this really consequential information that if you don't know it or if you don't pay attention to it, has consequences from a variety of sources, to take that data and make it available to people, giving it context and calculations where necessary, and then make it actionable information. Consequential information and actionable information isn't the same thing. If you don't have the right context, if you don't know where it fits, that action may not do much good. So that's what we're talking about, making actionable information out of all the data sources that you may find in manufacturing.